Hello. Today we are going to make a piece of fabric using the same basically technique as we did in previously published instructions, fabric 1, fabric 2, and etc. Inflate a balloon leaving about 8-inch flat tail. We are going to twist 24 bubbles, all of the same about thumbnail size. Twist a chain of 5 bubbles. We are going to use just one balloon to make one rectangular shape. A piece of fabric. The size of the rectangle is 4x6 bubbles. Okay, we made a chain of 5 bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Now we twist a chain of the next 6 bubbles. It's important to twist bubbles of the same size for this sculpture. Otherwise, the rectangle won't be rectangular. Okay, now we lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 12th bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 12 bubbles in one lock twist. We've just made 2x6 rectangle. Twist a chain of the next 2 bubbles. Lock the free end of the chain of the last 2 bubbles between the nearest 2 bubbles. We have to pull gently the end of the balloon through the loop of bubbles. Try to roll bubbles around the balloon to reduce friction. Here one of the bubbles untwisted, so I have to twist it back. Now we twist a chain of the next 3 bubbles. As you can see, we work from the center of the rectangle, going from one side to the other side. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Again, we have to force the end of the balloon through the loop of bubbles. We have made 3/4 of the rectangle. Twist a chain of the next 5 bubbles. So, how many we have made so far? Here's the 5th bubble of the chain. Now we have to lock the free end of the last, it is the 22nd bubble, between the 2 bubbles at the corner on the long side of the rectangle. Twist the next, the 23rd bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 24th bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 24 bubbles in one lock twist. Congratulations, we have made the rectangle. Cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end. We can use this rectangular shape to make many different sculptures. Flags, cakes, furniture, you name it. We can connect number of these small size rectangles to make larger size rectangles. Also, the fabric is very flexible, so we can bend it to shape it in very different 3D objects. Here we have a red rectangle. Here I'm using a permanent black marker, just for an example to make a flag of former Soviet Union. I don't have a gold marker to do it properly. Please excuse me for that. Also with a gold marker we can draw the Chinese flag. Now we are going to attach a couple of rectangles to make a larger rectangle. Twist a chain of 2 bubbles. We will attach long sides of rectangles. like the free end of the second yellow bubble, between two red bubbles at the corner on the long side of the rectangle. We are going to make the second rectangle in the same fashion as we have made the first, the red rectangle. In this example, we attach the yellow balloon to already previously made red rectangle. We twist and lock the yellow bubbles between red bubbles on the long side of the rectangle. Okay, it looks like I am doing and saying same thing over and over again. Alright then, let's first play this part of the video clip. Congratulations, at this point we have made a square 6x6 bubbles. We use very small size bubbles in this sculpture. It makes it difficult to attach new balloons. There is easier way to attach new balloons. Just make two or more rectangles at the same time. Here comes the purple balloon. We attach it to the yellow balloon at the corner where the long side of the rectangle is going to be. Making two rectangles at the same time doesn't change how we make the rectangles. It helps just connect two rectangles, that's all. There are only three points on the long side where we have to attach the rectangles. So we don't really save much time by doing two rectangles. However, this is a safer way to connect balloons. Well, there is always a chance you may bust a balloon just by looking on it. Well, it happened. However, you are more likely to bust a balloon by forcing it through a small loop of bubbles. Okay, here we have connected balloons together. I'm going to first play this part of the video clip. We finish the rest of the yellow and then rest of the purple rectangle in the same way, in same fashion as we did the red rectangle previously. The front and the back of this sculpture have identical look. It makes it perfect to use as a flag. And there is a great number of national flags we can make using this technique. Actually, I have made a web page at fewdoit.com dedicated just for flags. Congratulations, we have made three rectangles connected in a rectangular shape. In this example, we use purple, yellow and red to make, I think, a flag of Chad. With a different colors, we can make different flags. In the following example, we are going to use two balloons to attach four small rectangles to make one large rectangle. Let's inflate two white balloons, leaving about 8-inch flat tails. Twist the first white bubble, lock the white bubble between two bubbles at the corner of the long side of the first rectangle. Take the second balloon and work it in the same fashion using the second rectangle. Tie together nozzles of white balloons. Twist the second white bubbles. Lock the free end of the second white bubbles in one lock twist. We work in this fashion both white balloons to the next corner on the long side of the rectangles. Again, I'm first playing this part of the video clip. It takes 6 bubbles to cover long side of the rectangle. Okay, now we're going to work each white balloon separately along short side of a rectangle. Here we twist an extra bubble just to get around the corner of the rectangle. Let's work this white balloon to the next corner on the short side of the rectangle. It takes 4 bubbles to cover the short side of the rectangle. Now we are going to attach the third rectangle. Twist the 12th white bubble. Lock the free end of the 12th bubble between 2 bubbles at the corner on the short side of the third rectangle. Work this white balloon along the short side of the rectangle. It's quite simple but time-consuming work. We are again approaching the center of our sculpture. Remember, at the center we have to twist an extra bubble to get around the corner of the rectangle. We need it just to keep our sculpture flat. We have made each small rectangle twisting 24 bubbles. And we twist each white balloon to make 22 bubbles. Okay, here at the center of our sculpture we have to stop for a second. It is time to work the second white balloon. We do it in the same fashion. Extra bubble in the center. So again I'm going to first play this part of the video clip. Here we attach the fourth small rectangle. Work down the short side to the corner of the rectangle. It takes total of 140 bubbles to make this big size rectangle. Quite a work, isn't it? Here at the center of the sculpture we twist the extra bubbles, lock them. And now we work both white balloons down the long side of the rectangles. There is nothing complicated, so let me first play this part of the video clip. This sculpture is good to make a flag. You just have to pick up proper colors to make your flag. In this example, it looks similar to Dominican Republic flag. I just have to use red balloon instead of orange. I'm going to post more pictures of flags on my blog and at viewdoit.com. Just check it out. Congratulations, we have made big rectangle. We use small rectangle to make different size rectangles. Have fun and happy twisting!